Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello student, welcome back. This is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Today we will study the second experiment of VTU syllabus, that is for the fourth semester of IS and CS students, that is Microcontroller and Embedded System Laboratory. So, the second experiment is write the program to find the sum of first 10 integers. We have to find the sum of test first 10 integers. For that, this is the algorithm. Let us go to directly program. So, in this program, I have taken separate area for data. In that, I have defined one memory location, sum of type DCD, defined constant data. Initially, I have assigned the value 0, that is, I initialized this sum with the 0. Define constant data means it will allocate one or two words of memory locations. I repeat, words of memory locations, and these words are aligned with the 4-byte boundaries. These words are aligned with 4-byte boundaries. So, it will allocate one or more words of memory location, and these are aligned with the 4 bytes of memory boundaries. Now, the program starts with the TTL statement. We know TTL is nothing but title. Title given here is integer sum. Then followed by area statement. For the particular area where you are writing program, the label is given program 2 and it contains code and it is mapped to read only memory. So it starts with the entry. Entry is the starting point of the program. Initially you can see I have assigned the address. I have assigned the address to register R0, address of this sum location to register R0 by using LDR statement, load register. Then I have taken here one register R1. This register R1 is initialized with the 1. This is called as a loop iterator. Loop iterator means I want to count starting from 0, then 1, then 2, then 3 till 10 integers. So what I did is to repeat for 10 times I have taken R1 and I have initialized that with 1, and I have taken one more register R2 and initialized that with 0, this value 0. Now what I do is I will compare R1 with 10. If it is 10, that means when you execute at some point of time, it will become 10. That means if it is 10, then it will directly jump to store this location and it will store the result in the particular memory location. That is, if it is a 10, compare R1 is equal to 10, branch if equal, store. BEQ means branch if equal. That means if R1 is equal to 10, then this results in zero flag activation. If R1 is equal to 10, this results in zero flag activation. Based on this condition, this BEQ works. BEQ works, branch if equal works based on the previous instruction status. So in that case, it will jump to store. Otherwise, what it will do? It will add with carry R1 to R2. So what is there in the R1 initial case? R1 is 1, R2 is 0. That means we are adding 0 and 1, and the result is stored in R2. Then I will increment R1 with one more by 1. That is, now R1 becomes 2. Then this will repeat. Second time it will check whether R1 is equal to 10. No, now our case is R1 is equal to 2. Then 2 is added to the earlier result. And this step will repeat for 10 times. So once R1 becomes 10, it will come out. After that, where is our result? Result is in R2. We will store the result in R2 in R0 memory location. Please remember, this is memory location. Anything in bracket is address. So it will store the result of R2 in memory location by using store register. Store register. Then we have stop be stop is used to loop the program counter at this point only. Now we'll see how to execute this program. To execute this program, let me start. Microvision Keil version 4. Keil Microvision 4 version. So you know, when you start any program, Keil version 4, if any project is open, you have to close that project. Let me close the open project first. Then I'll start with new project. Project new Microvision project. So under new Microvision project, I will create the folder here first. Let me create the folder here. Anyway, I have created the folder software 2. Software 2, I have created the new folder software 2. Software 2 means second experiment, software 2. I will give the project name. Project name is PROJ2, project 2. And I will save this one. Then it will pop up to select the target device. In my case, target device is LPC2148. So you have to select LPC2148. In my last video, I have explained you the details of LPC2148, what it contains exactly, like what is the data size, then what is the flash memory size. All this information I have given, please go through it. I will click on OK. So now we'll hear it will pop up to copy startup.file. Since we write the program in assembly language, startup.file is not required. I can click on no. Now it has created the target. Under the target you can see source group. Then now the next stage is I have to create the file. To create the file, I have to click on file and new Microvision file. So before proceeding, you have to save this file. This is the text editor. Here you have to write the program. So before proceeding, you have to save the file. So in my case, I have already written the file, this one program. I will open that program. Let me close this one. I will open that program. Open. And this is the program. So this is the program to add 10 numbers. This program is already saved. If you want, you can save it once again. And you have to add this program to the source group. So what you have to do is to add this program to the source group. So double click on the source group. That is the one option. Otherwise, right click on the source group, add files to the groups, second option. Select the file. When you click here, when you click, double click on the source group, you will see this window. Here, you will not find your file. This is because the file type given is here, C source file, but we have written the program in assembly language file. So you have to select ASM source file. That time you can see your file is there. This is my file. Click on that, close. Now you, if you expand this one, you can see this is the file. Once the program is written, you have to compile it. To compile it, you have to click this icon, or you can press Ctrl F7 also, click this icon. It shows zero errors and zero warnings. Then build and rebuild. Over. After this, you have to debug the program. To debug the program, you have to go to debug, start and stop. Otherwise, you have shortcut key here. Click on debug. So it will open in evaluation mode. The meaning of evaluation mode is the code size can be maximum can be 32 KB. So when you click on this one, it will open three windows. One is a register window, other one is a disassembly window, third one is our code window, and we have output window, and memory windows. So now to execute the program one by one, you can use this button, that is step F11. So when you click on step F11, it will when you click on this button, it will take several iteration because it has to count the sum of 10 numbers. At least it will take here 10 iterations. We'll see that one. So I'll click here. I'll keep on clicking this one. So it will execute first time, second time, third time, like that. It will execute till it counts 10 numbers. You can see here. Once 10 number is over, now if you click this one, our program counter is here. You can see stop be stop. So if you click further click, it will not move. That means it has executed, and result here, result is in R2 because we have stored the final result in R2, right? We have stored the final result in R2. So you can see what is the result in R2, that is 2D. This is the one way. Other way is, suppose the number is 10. If you want to find out the sum of 100 integers, then you have to click so many times. It requires so many iterations, like 100 iterations. So how to come out from this one? For that, let me stop once again this debugging. And I will start once again debugging. Now, you can see here, run F5. That means start the code execution and it will execute the entire code once and you will get the result. Let me execute this one. And now it has executed the entire code and you can see the result is 2D. Result is 2D, that is in R2. But you can see in our program, we have stored the content of R2 in R0 location, right? R0 location. What is R0? R0 is 0x4000. In this location, we have stored the result. I want to see that in memory. To see that in memory, you have to go to project memory windows. Suppose windows, if doesn't appear, once again click on view and memory windows. And here you type 0x4 followed by 7 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Enter. Then you can see here, this one, 2D. It has taken 4 locations to store the result. Our result is here. You can see 2D. Our result is here, 2D. So in this way, we have executed the second program. Suppose if you want to do changes to the program, you can't do in a debugging mode. Any changes you can do in a normal mode only. For that you have to stop the debugging. When you stop the debugging, it will come to the normal editing mode where you can do the changes. So this is second experiment to find out the sum of 10 integers. Thank you.